they're talking about shorts. Shorts, and about sucking the baby.
Tom,
you're Charlie, right?
How do you know?
I've seen you around.
What's your name?
Nola.
Tomorrow?
If you decide to consider us for the shoot tomorrow.
Then tighten you next week.
I'll see you next week then.
Tomorrow? Same time?
Sure. I was just taking a little change for the carnival.
How much you got?
100.
Take another 100.
You mean that, Charlie?
Yes, I mean that. Now put on your clothes and don't ever come back here.
But Charlie, I thought...
That is the door.
Boys are under the mango tree, close to home, everybody enjoying breadfruit and what?
Smoked fish.
Right? Here today is stuffing, we just eat some corn, we had our fire pot here, the fire is still burning. You have two more breadfruit for you all, but sorry, you all not here to get the two. But these guys are just having a good time. Everybody have their own breadfruit. Everybody. Look mine there. I'm trying to peel some across there. That's my plate there. Boy, smoked fish. Everything smells good here, boy. Watch it. It's stuffing, boy. You guys miss out a lot when you come the next time. Frankie here, yeah, he's doing it too. Only me ain't started eat yet, but I'm going. Are you looking to cut up something here? Yeah? I'm looking to cut up something. Bread food to kill, man.
Good morning, everyone. This is my reflection on Cecil. Cecil had many names, Washan being the most famous, and Charlie. One of the best things Cecil ever did for me was to introduce me to someone who is now my dear husband, Carlisle, and for that, I am ever so grateful. Cecil was always the funny one. What was amazing was that he always had a serious look on his face, but very funny and fun-loving. A couple years ago, I had some challenges. I went home for a visit and to relax. I was left with some nerve pain in both feet, and so one day, Cecil came and picked both Deanne and myself up and took us to a beautiful private spot in Mount Irvin. He had me walk to and fro in the sand, telling me it will help, and to my surprise, it did. The last visit to Tobago was in 2019. He came and picked me up in Old Road one morning very early and took me to one of his favorite spots, which was Lambo Beach, where he said he enjoyed walking, listening to the birds, listening to the different sounds, enjoying the breeze and the rising sun, and praying. And he wanted me to share that experience with him. I enjoyed our walk and conversation, not knowing that would be the last time I would be communicating with my brother in person. Cecil had his faults, but he had a good heart and loved his family. I witnessed Cecil give his life to Christ, and the only name he knew at the end was God. We as siblings are happy, and that is our comfort, knowing he did that. This is a celebration time, not a sad time. He will be missed. Yes, he will be missed. Cecil was everyone's chauffeur, and he enjoyed what he did for family, friends, and visitors to the island. He also loved art, especially as a young boy. We also know acting was a talent which was quickly recognized by Horace Wilson, one of our local writers and a very good family friend. Cecil acted in Turn of the Tide as Charlie alongside Dr. Eastland McKenzie, who was his sister, Tiny. We enjoyed that miniseries. His siblings made voice notes and played them for him while he was in the hospital. He indicated to Deanne that he heard by squeezing her hand. We tend to speak nicely about people after they die when they cannot hear. But we made sure he knew how much we loved him and that we were happy he accepted Christ as his Lord and Savior. Before I end, I just want to say, God knows better than us. God allowed the affliction of Cecil's body for the benefit of his soul. We have to give thanks always. God causes all things to work together for good to them that love him. The pain is there, but there is a limitation to it. We just have to respond the right way. Cecil has gone, but he will always live on in our hearts. We will remember his jokes, his playfulness, his silliness. We will miss him. My brother Cecil, rest in peace.
Hi, I'm Aaron from the UK. I'm so sorry that I can't be there to say farewell to Cecil because of the situation around the world at the moment. My heart is so broken that I will not be there. Cecil and I has grown up as brothers from another mom. He was my neighbor, my friend, my trusted colleague, and everything. I can't believe he's gone. He was a very, very peaceful, trustworthy person that he could rely on to have anything done. If I asked him to help or to look into anything for me, he was always there to do it for me, especially if I was to arrive at the airport, he was there to pick me up. You will be missed, my brother. You will be missed very much. He was also the part of the original old boys crew, such as Lindy, Frankie, Ainsley, Wayne, Errol Gray. And myself, Aaron. We will never forget him. He will always be in our hearts. You will be missed so very much, Cecil. Rest in peace, my brother, until we meet again.
invite you to stand. All right. We are indeed living in some strange times and having to do some strange things. But all in all, we give God thanks and we give Him praise for all His blessings, for His mercies. We do not live to ourselves, and we do not die to ourselves. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, so that He might be Lord of both the dead and the living. May the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ be praised. In His great mercy, by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, He gave us new birth into a living hope, the hope of an inheritance reserved in heaven, which nothing can destroy, spoil, or wither. As a father has compassion for his children, so the Lord has compassion for those who fear Him. As a mother comforts her child, so will I comfort you, says the Lord. He will feed His flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in His arms and carry them in His bosom. We would not have you ignorant, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with Him those who have died. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, You love us with an everlasting love and can turn the shadow of death into the light of a new dawn. Help us now to wait upon You with reverent and submissive hearts. In the silence of this hour, speak to us of eternal things, that we with patience and the comfort of Your holy word may embrace and hold fast the blessed hope of eternal life, which You have given us through Your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and the Savior. Amen. I think we can sing one song. Yes. All right. So I'm going to ask us to remain standing, and we're going to sing that hymn that we have here. Precious Lord, take my hand. Lead me on. Let me stand. I am tired. I am weak. And I am worn. Precious Lord, take my hand. Lead me on, let me stand. I'm tired, I'm weak, I'm worn. Through the storm, through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my way goes drear, when my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. find and I draws near, and the day is on and gone. At the river I stand, guide my feet, hold my hand, take my hand. Precious Lord, lead me home. Amen. You may have your seat. At this time I invite our dear sister, Mackenzie, to come and share reflection.
These reflections, the content, everything was put together by his dear sister Diane, and I am just presenting it on behalf of all of them. Cecil Cuthbert Adams, also known as Washhand, was born on the 8th of September 1957. Many of you might be curious how he got the name Washhand. As a young boy fresh out of school, he was sent to Tobago Services to learn the mechanic trade. He just couldn't stand to see his hands black and oily, so he washed his hands at every opportunity he got, even leaving customers with their car bonnets open while he raced for the sink. If all you think, all you washing hand plenty with this COVID-19, nobody could have beat wash hand. He was the fourth child of his father and the first of four siblings from the union of his father and mother, Cuthbert and Evelyn Adams, both deceased. As a child, Cecil was very serious, seldom smiled, and this was reflected in most of his photographs. He was strong-willed, with strong opinions that could seldom be changed, no matter how hard one tried. He spoke his mind, and he didn't sugarcoat anything for anybody. Nevertheless, there was another side to Cecil that his family and close friends knew too well. He had a big heart, was very helpful, and loved to see others happy and enjoying themselves. Additionally, he was the comic of the family. Apart from getting his siblings into trouble, mark you, not good trouble, you know, proper trouble, he always had them laughing with his antics and jokes. He was also their movie star, as he starred in a local production written by Horace Wilson, Turn of the Tide. Yes, he was my little brother. All you remember Charlie? Well, let me tell all you how Charlie get into Turn of the Tide. Horace Wilson, who wrote the script, was neighbor and friend to the Adams family, so Curtis was his boy. But in the movie, Cecil, Charlie was the one who used to transport and drive and so on and thing. And one day when he saw what we were doing in the play, he said, Boris, I could do that too. So Horace wrote in a part in the script to suit Charlie, Cecil. So there was Cecil. You didn't have to train him. He was just a natural that fitted in, and I believe Horace wrote according to the person he knew Cecil was. But in the play, Cecil had a wife. But the wife was this young lady, Miss Habib, Elsa Habib, in the play was his wife. But he used to like Lady B, the late Lady B, Beulah Bob. So he make him move. So anyhow, when the time come, the wife can't find Cecil. Can't find Charlie, where Charlie is and so on. So something gives you a little zeppo that Charlie gone by this guest house with this keeper man. So she gone to the guest house, and who was the person there in the bar mixing drinks? And so Eric Powder, he have a long Spanish name, blah, 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 my name, blah, 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 but they just call me Chico. So she gone to Chico. Chico said, oh gosh, the last time I seen him, he had a roasting fever. The boy had a fever, oh gosh, I don't know. He must be still there, let me. God, my dear, hey, your wife there looking for you. She promised to broke down the door. Oh God, Cecil, take water, throw up on his skin and say how the fever make his sweat wet up all the clothes when he come out and so. And that was that part. And next time, Cecil Charlie gone to the lady priest in the church, knock on the door. She said, what happened? He said, I come to you because I have a problem. She said, what problem do you have, brother? He said, listen up. The wife and I have 3 daughters. All of them is girls. So I come to you that the one she making now, if he's a girl, I want to put you up for adoption because I want a boy to carry on me need. Last one I have to tell you about Charlie. Wedding going on in Turn of the Tide. Charlie, dear boy, seeing he and his wife sit down and son. When he look wrong, he keep him and come on. Charlie there in the church making sweet eye and wink eye for Lady B and his wife there. That was the kind of man he was in Turn of the Tide. He deserves a round of applause. Let me hear you. He was an ardent artist. One of his murals can be seen on the wall adjacent to the Scarborough Library. He was also a part of a group that made greeting cards from banana leaves. Cecil was the life of a party. He knew how to entertain. He was a part-time taxi operator and loved taking tourists on tours, showing off Tobago. He thoroughly enjoyed that vocation and he was really good at it. Reflecting back to his childhood, he was extremely mischievous. He would put away his toys, play with his siblings' toys. When their toys were all broken up and can't be used again, Cecil will come out with his new, bright and shiny toy that none of them could touch because his stare at them was just like the growl of a dog that if you attempted to touch his bowl of food or bone, how that dog would growl. He made lots of mischief nevertheless. They were a tight-knit clan and secret agent for each other. Nobody squealed on one another. So the father, when he could not find out who did something, would line them up in the order of their birth. Cecil, Curtis, then Diane, and Denise to deliver the flogging. And before he flogged would say, Peter will pay for Paul and Paul will pay for all. Diane often wondered, what that had to do with me and Denise? He ain't called no girl name. All his boy, Peter and Paul. Cecil, before the flogging, would give his siblings a strategy so that they wouldn't get plenty licks. When his father went to retrieve the belt, he would whisper to the rest of them, lift up all your hand high and then pull it back fast. When the belt come down and hit daddy pants and make a loud noise, grab all your hand and cry hard. Guess what? They say it used to work. They would only receive 2 out of 4 or 5 lashes. All you see how early he started to prepare for Turn of the Tide. All the children had their chores to do, and Cecil was given the responsibility for feeding the pigs. His mother on occasions wanted to know why she tomato, ketchup, and she mayonnaise and sugar. How they finishing so quick? She later discovered Cecil used to put them to sweeten the pig food because he said the food need to taste better for the pig them. Even game gave some of the pigs that look skinny to him. He used to give them yeast to fatten them up. Cecil showed Curtis how to sneak out the house to attend basement parties without the parents knowing. He stuffed shirts and pants in the form of persons and placed them in sleeping positions, covered them up in bed, placed pillow on the pillows as he balled up the heads, make them look like heads. He did this because he knew that his mother always, during the course of the night, turn on the light, peep in the children's room to make sure they were asleep. Diane and Denise, check. Cecil and Curtis, check. Then she would return to their bedroom. His actions were short-lived. On one of these occasions, he come home drunk. Couldn't remember how he got to bed. His father found a ladder up against an open window in the living room. Guess what? The next day, the father changed all the windows to louvers. Reflecting further, the home had a Sylvania television, black and white. Daddy only allowed the children to watch panorama news, and after that, every man jack gone to your bed, soon as the news finished. Cecil waited until his daddy fell asleep. As soon as he heard the first two snores, he wake up his sibling. Say, look, come on, tiptoe to the living room. We go in and watch Dark Shadows. Dark Shadows begin 9 o'clock. No lights on. When the father stirred, Cecil jump up, turn a knob on the TV that made the whole screen turn black. He lowered the volume right down and told the brothers and sisters, lie low, keep quiet. His father visited the kitchen, drink water, gone to the bathroom, back to bed. He wasn't one to check rooms. When Cecil heard the first two snores, he called out, hey, the coast is clear. Let's go back and watch Dark Shadows. There were other occasions his father retired to bed very early and reminded the children after news, find all your bed. On those occasions, Cecil would ensure the clock that chimed every quarter hour and very loud on the hour. He wrap it up in a pillow as he held it outside a window so that the sound that the chimes of the clock would not wake his father. Gave them another 2 hours or so viewing time, because no clock now chime, he now know the time. The challenge was that the next day, his mother had a task waking up the children, oftentimes have to return to their rooms with a broomstick to get them up and ready for school. They're watching Dark Shadows till midnight. On yet another occasion, he got his siblings into trouble when he drank out a bottle of Solo, the clear cream soda flavored Solo, and he filled up the bottle with what? Water. Put on the cap and he placed it back into the case. The father loved entertaining. Friends come, poured out some Solo for one of them, only to discover this thing now fizzle up. He now got was actually water. I don't need to tell you what followed. His stories are too numerous to tell all at this time, but will forever be etched in the hearts of his loved one. On his sickbed, he always had his sister and Camille in stitches. When they doubled over in laughter, his comment would be, "All you only laughing and man lie down here in pain." He retained his sense of humor to the end. 4 days before he passed, he cried out to the Lord and pleaded with him, saying that he could not bear the pains anymore, telling the Lord, "God, you know what to do." He was hospitalized the next day and peacefully went to his earthly rest 2.5 days after that. Through it all, Cecil accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as his personal savior, and this brought comfort and joy to his family, knowing that he used the time of his illness to make it right with God. One thing they know is that he wanted everybody to know, we cannot put our trust in man, but must place all our trust in Almighty God, as only He can save us all. Says, Charlie, brother, friend, companion, your sense of humor your kindness, your willingness to help others, your genuine love for family and friends will be greatly missed, but we have fond memories. Sleep in peace, beloved brother. May your dearly departed soul rest in eternal peace. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Doc, for sharing the life and times of our dear departed. At this time, I'm going to invite two persons so assigned to come and share the scripture reading. Ecclesiastes 3, 1-8, and John 14, 1-6. Dotsy, Marcus, yes.
Good morning, Christian friends. The reading is taken from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, reading from verse 1-8. To everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to cast away. A time to rend and a time to sow. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. This is the word of the Lord.
Good morning, everyone. This second reading is taken from John 14, verses 1-6. Volume. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Thanks be to God.
Just to remind us that to everything there is a season, a time to be born, and a time to die, and the death today, the death of our dear departed brother today, is a reminder that life on this earth will come to an end sometime, and it is very important that we prepare ourselves before death comes. And it is my prayer that we will use our time wisely and make our calling and election sure, even as death speaks to us at this time. Let's all stand as we sing the hymn, "To God Be the Glory. Great things He has done." To God be the glory, great things He has done. So loved Thee the world that He gave us His Son, who yielded His life and atonement for sin, and opened the life gate that all may go in. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, let the earth hear His voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father, to Jesus the Son, and give Him the glory, great things He has done. Your perfect redemption, the purchase of God, to every believer, the promise of God, the vilest offender who truly believes. That moment from Jesus, a pardon receive. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The earth hear His voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father, through Jesus the Son, and give Him the glory, great things He has done. Great things He has taught us, great things He has done.
And greater rejoicing through Jesus His Son.
But purer and higher and greater will be our wonder around for when Jesus we see. Praise the Lord, let the earth hear His voice. Praise the Lord, let the people rejoice. Oh, come to the Father, through Jesus the Son, and give Him the glory, great things He has done. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. By Your human birth, by Your obedience and faithfulness, by Your prayers and tears, by Your agony and passion, by Your dying words, by Your reconciling death, by Your rest in the grave, by Your triumphant resurrection, by Your abiding presence, bless and comfort us, O Lord. Let us pray together the prayer which our Lord taught His disciples. O Father, hallowed be Thy name. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For Thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever. Amen. Eternal God, before whose face the generation rise and pass away, we bless and praise Your name for all who have departed this life in faith, and especially for our dear Cecil Adams. For all Your kindness to him throughout his earthly life, we give You thanks. We thank You that for him all sickness and sorrow are ended, and that death itself is past. Almighty God, may we, inspired by the example of Your saints, run with patience the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, so that when this mortal life is ended, we may be gathered with those whom we have loved in the kingdom of your glory, where there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things have passed away through Jesus Christ our Lord. O God, our Father, by whom we are led through the changes of time to the rest and blessedness of eternity, be near us to comfort and uphold. Make us to know that your people are precious in your sight, and that they live evermore with you. As we thank you for our dear departed brother whose life we shared, may we trust you at this time of parting. O God, give us of your strength that we may take up our lives more bravely and seek to be more faithful in duty and more loving and helpful to others, following those who are no longer with us here on earth. And may we, in our turn, find in your great mercy the perfect and unending rest of God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us commend Curtis Adams to the mercy of God our Maker. Cecil Adams. Doc, I'm following you. Cecil Adams to the mercy of God our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Father, by your power you gave us life, and in your love you have given us new life in Jesus Christ. We entrust Cecil Adams to your merciful keeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again that we might enjoy eternal life. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and by the blessings of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be upon us and remain with us always. Amen. As we will sing a song, and so that our videographer can organize himself over at the graveside. Which one is it then? It is well? Okay. Thank you. Let us continue with the service of committal. Jesus said, set your troubled hearts at rest. Trust in God always. Trust also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you, I am going to prepare a place for you. We know that when our earthly frame is destroyed, we possess a building provided by God, eternal and in heaven. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. All who have faith in me shall live even though they die. No one who lives and has faith in me shall ever die. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? Thanks be to God who gives the victory to Jesus Christ our Lord. We have entrusted Cecil Adams to God's merciful keeping, and we now commit his body to the ground. Dust to dust, ash to ash, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. So to him be glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. O Father of all, we pray for those whom we love but see no longer. Grant them your peace. Let light perpetual shine upon them. And in your loving wisdom and almighty power, working them the good purpose of your perfect will through Jesus Christ our Lord. Almighty God, Father of all mercy and giver of all comfort, deal graciously with all who mourn, that casting every care upon you, they may know the consolation of your love through Jesus Christ our Lord. O Lord, support us all the day long of this troublous life, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes. The busy world is hushed, the fever of life over and our work done. Then, O Lord, in your mercy, grant to us and those we love safe lodging, holy rest, and peace at the last through our Lord Jesus Christ. Rejoicing in the communion of the saints, we thank you for all your servants who have departed in the faith, the great cloud of witnesses by whom we are encompassed, who in every age have loved you in life and continued faithful unto death, especially those most dear to our own hearts. Give us grace with them to follow you and bring us at the last to those things which eye has not seen nor ear heard, which you have prepared for them that love you. Amen.
Clear for me, let me hide myself in thee.
Let the water and the blood from the ravens I could flow. Be your sinner, double pure. Cleanse me from
its guilt and fall.
Let the labor of my hand
and fulfill thy law's demand. Turn my sin, O Israel, turn my tears forever flow. All for sin, turn not alone, and our sever down alone. Nothing in my hands I bring, simply to cross I cling,
make it come
to thee for dress,
helpless love to thee for grace, all I do the problem flies.
Wash me, Savior, or I die.
Close in death.
Thank you. Thank you. tonight. The peace of the Lord continues to be with you all, even as we feel about this time. Huh?
There's something else I would like to say. I know there's going to be a thank you at the end, but this is my thank you. I am not able to be there in person, but I just want to say first, thank you, Jehovah God, the great I am, the comforter. Thank you for your mercy, compassion, forgiveness, and support, especially at this time. Thank you for your comfort and reminding us of your love for us each and every day. Thank you to everyone who played a role in Cecil's life. Thank you to everyone who sent monetary donations, those who called, those who offered prayers and well wishes, those who visited him looking through the window at him. Thank you on behalf of my siblings and myself. I would like to say a special thank you to two ladies, Diane and Camille. Camille, words cannot express how my siblings and I feel. We appreciate you so much for being there through the ups and the downs. I know this experience over these past months have changed your life for the better. The many sleepless nights and still having to set up to go to work, to come back to help get Cecil organized, only God knew. God uses adversity to grow us up, equip us to learn how good God is. When the bottom falls out and no place to turn, He shows up, That's how awesome God is. I heard this mentioned this morning and it is so profound. Open quotation. God has allowed us to learn so that we can be of service to his people and not to hold them ransom. Closed quotation. Camille, you were of great service. And we just want to say thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And may God continue to bless and keep you. Deanne, my darling sister, you are God's anointed. You have touched so many lives and still continue to make an impact. You took care of Daddy, Tante Chrissy, Mommy, and now Cecil. Thank you. God bless you. God had his hand in this from the beginning. Deanne, you retired at the right time. Sometimes our loved ones or friends may not be who we want them to be, but guess what? No one is perfect, but we love them anyway. Many times you were tired or not feeling well, yet you were there to support Camille. As we heard growing up, God never gives you more than he knows you can bear. And God saw that you guys were tired, so he took his child home. Thank you. When things are going well in our lives, it's easy to have faith and trust, yet doubt may surface. But during those times, we affirm that with God, all things are possible, even when we do not personally see a desired completed result. We are faithfully aware of God's presence and power. We have to remember, whether you believe or not, everything comes from God. Thank you, Deanne. Thank you. You're a blessed person. May God continue to bless you with great health and long life to continue his work. You have finished one task, and may he prepare you for the next. Curtis, thank you for going and spending quality time with Cecil. Cecil enjoyed having you in his last days. He enjoyed just chatting and reminiscing about childhood days. One thing he had to the end was his sense of humor. And he would make Camille and Deanne laugh every time they went to take care of him. He still had his sense of humor. Thank you, Curtis. To my other siblings, Shirley, Vi, thank you all for the support, encouragement, prayers. May God continue to bless you all. To his friends that I know of, I know he had more friends, but I don't know their names. But I just want to say a special thank you to Zelma Sandy. Thank you for supporting us, for being there when we needed you. Thank you to Bernadette. You are special, very, very special to us. Thank you. To Lindy, you were like a brother to Cecil. He respected and cherished your friendship. You all had a long history. Thank you for everything you did for him. May God continue to bless your hands,
to continue helping other people. Special thanks to Leno. You were there for Deanne and Camille, and I thank you. Thank you. Ainsley and Haron, Ozzy, Frankie, among others, thank you for being his friend. He cherished you guys. Always sending videos to Ainsley and Haron, tempting them with his mangoes, etc. Thank you guys. Thank you very much. To my other family and friends, those that are near, those that are abroad, thank you for your prayers and support. Thank you, Dutsy and Dr. Mack, for supporting us. Thanks to Belgrove Funeral Home for putting out and making our brother look dapper and distinguished. To you, Wendell Phillips, CEO of Magnificent Productions, thank you for everything. Thanks for supporting us by live streaming so that everyone is able to view Cecil's homegoing celebration. May God continue to show you his favor. Thank you again to everyone. May God bless you all.